Hallelujah. Greetings to all the brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah. 大家弟兄姐妹平安。
This evening, we're going to share the topic of grace in the midst of suffering.
今天晚上要与大家分享的题目是苦难中的恩典。
Being a Christian, we always pray that God will bless us and bring us grace.
当你成为一个基督徒的时候，你总是在祷告当中会想到求主耶稣赐恩典。
When we think about grace, immediately we may relate it to all the blessings, all the good life and smooth sailing in our life.
当我们想到恩典呢，可能就会联想到生活当中的一切的顺遂，或者是很好的工作，很好的薪水。
Yeah, very healthy, your job is very stable, and your family is very complete.
你的生活非常的愉快，家庭美满，然后薪水、工作都很稳定。
And when we encounter suffering, we think that it's a bad thing, and we pray and pray and pray that it will get over with it and be far away from it.
那我们在患难中的时候，很自然就会向神祷告，求神把这个患难拿走，让我们可以尽快回到平静的生活。
Because in our mind, grace and suffering are totally separate and unrelated.
因为在我们的观念里面，患难跟恩典完全是截然不同的事情。
However, if we go deeper into the Bible, grace and suffering are always together.
不过，如果我们在圣经当中查考的话，你会发现苦难与恩典常常是连结在一起的。
Recently, we have been reading the book of Exodus in our Bible reading schedule.
最近我们读经进度已经来到出埃及记。
The book of Exodus is about deliverance and God's salvation to His people.
出埃及记已经来到神的拯救，还有神的带领。
But in order to receive God's deliverance, people has to go through suffering.
那在神的拯救出现之前，人民必须受苦。
And let's look at how the Bible begin to describe the background.
那我们来看一下圣经如何用这个当作开场白。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter, Exodus chapter 1, verse 5 or 7.
我们来看出埃及记第一章五到七节。
Exodus chapter 1 verse 5。
出埃及记一章第五节，凡从雅各而生的共有七十人，约瑟已经在埃及。六。
Six。
约瑟和他的弟兄并那一代的人都死了。七。
Seven。
以色列人生养众多，并且繁茂极其强盛，满了那地。
Here the Bible said the generation of Joseph.And the brothers, older generation, has passed away.
圣经这里说，约瑟和他的弟兄并那一代的人都死了。
We finished the book of Genesis. At the end, we know that Joseph was the prime minister of Egypt, and he bring all his family into the land.
我们读到创世纪的最后，我们就明白约瑟成了埃及的宰相，并且把他家族的人全部都带到了埃及。
If not because of Joseph, they all died of hunger, famine, and starvation.
如果不是因为约瑟的关系，他们全部都会在饥荒当中死去。
But because of God's arrangement, they're all saved.
那因为神的计划，他们都被拯救了。
And then they live a good life.
他们在埃及生活得很好。
However, the Bible said here, Joseph plus all his generation has passed away.
但是这里已经提到约瑟和他的弟兄那一代的人都死了。
They didn't die of hunger.
他们并不是在饥荒当中死了。
But maybe they died later of other reasons.
当然，到最后不可能长命百岁的。
Usually they die of old age.
通常是在年老的时候死去。
Or maybe of some other sickness.
或者是生病当中。
So one by one, the whole generation are gone.
所以一个接着一个，慢慢的整代人都死了。
And the new generation replaced them.
新的一代的人就崛起。
For the past 1.5 years in this pandemic,A lot of people were wiped out. Many people died.
在过去一年半当中，因为疫情的关系，已经有好多人死去。
Even now, in some other country, when the pandemic is not controlled, some people are still dying every single minute.
就算到今天，在其他有些国家，疫情没有受到控制，还是有很多人死去。
So for those of us in Canada, we are lucky enough, we are blessed enough to have good health care, we receive vaccine, and we are pretty healthy.
我们住在加拿大的人非常有福气，因为我们有免费的医疗、免费的注射疫苗，所以我们都活得很好。
However, one day we all just like the Bible recorded, the generation will be one by one disappear and go.
不过，就像圣经这里记载，慢慢的，我们这一代的人就会一个接一个走了。
I remember in the old days when we have group pictures, when we attend church event, we take or after service we take group picture.
以前常常在教会的一些活动或是聚会之后，我们会照一个团体照。
And then the younger one usually stay at the very back.
那年轻的人可能会站在最后面。
And then, or you're younger, you're on the left or the very right.
你如果是很年轻的人，你可能站在后排的左右。
However, when your age grow older, suddenly you start to move up, and then you move middle.
当你年纪渐长之后，你就会往前排挪动。
If one day when you take group picture, people say, "Hey, let's come, brother, let's sister, let's in the front row," and you know what you mean.
当有一天大家要照团体照的时候，有人请你说，哎，弟兄或是姐妹，请你来坐在最前排，你就知道那是什么意思了。
Or you sit in the middle, and you know what you mean.
如果大家请你坐在前排又正中间，你就知道那是什么意思了。
Of course, you feel good, you are respected, right?
当然，你可能觉得还不错，因为你被尊重。
But at the same time, you are in the very front in the lineup.
不过，当你觉得你坐在最前排的时候，
you are in the front.
你坐在最前面。
And then you are, you know, just like generation, you belong to the older generation.
那很有可能你就是属于最老的那一代。
But anyway, people come and people pass.
那当然，一代又来，一代走了，一代又来。
Now, when the life is good, they receive blessing and grace.
那当你生活过得很顺遂的时候，你就是得到很多的恩典与福气。
Let's read verse 7.
我们来看第七节。以色列人生养众多，并且繁茂极其强盛，满了那地。
This one verse describes a period of time that the Israelites they were so smooth sailing, they were so blessed.
这一节记载了以色列人在埃及地有一段时间过得非常的好。
They have good environment and they are multiplying exceedingly great.
他们有很好的环境，让他们繁茂生养众多。
Many children, many grandchildren, and suddenly the family become big.
他们有很多的孙子曾孙，所以整个家族变得非常庞大。
Probably they eat good food, they enjoy good life.
可能每天都吃得很好，过得很好。
People are healthy.
而且很健康。
But don't forget, this momentary prosperity or good life are only short term.
可是我们要记得，这些繁茂还有强盛，其实都只是暂时的。
Usually, after a period of good selling and then wonderful abundant life, will followed by.A tough life or trials.
通常在繁茂及强盛之后，很有可能接着就是衰败，或者是萎缩
or suffering or tribulation.
或者是患难，或者是考验
So that brings the first point that suffering is destined.
所以这就带来我们的第一点，平安顺利中的恩典。
苦难是命定。
苦难是命定的。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 1, verse 8 to 11.
我们来看出埃及记第一章第八到十一节。
Exodus chapter 1, verse 8 to 11.
出埃及记第一章八到十一节。第八节，有不认识约瑟的新王起来治理埃及，对他的百姓说：看啊，这以色列民比我们还多，又比我们强盛。十，来吧，我们不如用巧计待他们，恐怕他们多起来，日后若遇什么征战的事，就联合我们的仇敌攻击我们，离开这地去了。十一节，于是埃及人派督工的辖制他们，加重担苦害他们。他们为法老建造两座基货城，就是比东和兰塞。
Wow, here we can see life can turn south, become very suddenly.
我们这里看见。有时候我们的生活就会像这里所提到的完全逆转。
Just like when you are very healthy, suddenly you feel strange and you go to see the doctor and the doctor tell you that you have a very serious illness.
就像你平常很健康，可是感觉不舒服，去看了医生之后，医生告诉你你已经得了绝症。
Or your career is very smooth and suddenly a financial crisis come and then your business facing a lot of trouble.
或者是你的生意其实本来很顺利，可是因为突然经济危机来到，你的生意就撑不下去了。
Just like what we describe here, and then the Israelites, their fortune was overturned overnight.
就像我们这里看见以色列人的生活在一夜之间改变了。
From a very smooth life, and then become a very tough life.
从非常顺利转变为非常的苦。
Why?
为什么?
Just because they changed the king.
因为他们换了一个新的王。
Because there's a new king came up who didn't know Joseph and what he did for the country.
因为有一个不认识约瑟的新王起来，他完全不知道约瑟为这个国家做过什么事。
And this new king didn't like that so many Israelites are there.
而且他也不喜欢这么多以色列人在埃及。
And this king afraid of these people.
而且他也怕这些百姓。
So he decided I'm going to do evil, try to suppress these people.
所以他说我们要派督工来辖制他们。
You know, brother and sister, when we work in a company, you know, right? If you have good supervisor, your life is very easy.
弟兄姐妹，我们都知道，如果你的管理你的人，这个组长他人非常好，你的日子就会过得不错。
But if you change supervisor, change your boss, suddenly your life go to hell, like, wow, you suffer.
如果你的组长或是你的老板突然间换人，而且换了一个不好的人，你就会过得很苦。
Or sometimes you change the president, change the prime minister, the government policy change, and your life totally turn upside down.
或者是国家里面的总理或者是总统突然换人，然后做了一些很不好的政策，我们的生活就会落入苦难当中。
Do not be very happy if life is very smooth right now.
所以我们不要为了今天的平顺而很开心。
Anything can change overnight.
什么事情都可以在一夜之间改变。
Nothing is forever. Nothing is everlasting.
没有什么东西是长存到永远的。
Now it seems that it is random. It is all unfortunate, and that they have a bad king and they have bad policy.
这里看起来好像只是一个很不幸，就是突然有一个新王，有一个新的政策出来。
However, the Bible tells us that suffering and troubles are destined, and that we're bound to happen to us.
可是圣经告诉我们，苦难是命定的，本来就在那里等我们。
Let's turn to the book of Job, chapter 5, verse 7.
我们来看约伯记第五章第七节。
The book of Job, chapter 5, verse 7.
约伯记第五章第七节。第七节，人生在世必遇患难，如同火星飞腾。
He said a man is born to trouble.
这里提到人生在世一定会遇到患难。
He didn't say that maybe they will have trouble.
并不是说很有可能。
Or sometime man will face trouble.
或者是有时候。
But actually you are born to it. You're 100% sure you will face it.
是百分之百必遇到患难。
It is just a matter of time.
就只是时间问题而已。
Some people when they face trouble when they're very young age.
有的人在少年的时候遇到患难。
Let's say they're born in a very unfortunate family, they lost their parent, or they're very poor.
可能生在很穷的家庭，或是年幼就失去亲人，
or they live in a very poor country,
或者是活在很穷的国家。
So their suffering they start very early in age.
所以在他们很小的时候就过得非常的苦。
Some people have a very good life when they were young, but in the middle age they suffer.
有的人是小时候日子过得很好，可是到中年就开始落入苦境。
Some people suffer when they old age in their sickness or their family problem.
有些人是在老年遇到家庭的问题或是健康的问题。
So there's no chance that you can escape from trouble.
所以其实我们没有可能避开患难的。
You are born to it. The Bible says we are born to it.
我们在世必遇患难。
Whether you are a believer or not, you will face it someday.
不管你相不相信，总有一天你会遇到的。
Why? Then you may ask, why people are bound to trouble? We are destined to it.
我们可能会问，为什么人生在世一定要遇到患难呢？
Now, if you look at the story, where did the Israelites stay? Where did we reside?
如果我们来看出埃及记，我们来看一下他们到底是活在什么样的世界。
They didn't live in their own country.
他们并不是活在自己的国家。
They live in the country of Pharaoh. They live in Egypt.
他们住在法老的世界，就是埃及。
If the Pharaoh treat them well, they will enjoy.
如果法老对他们不错，他们日子就过得好。
But if the Pharaoh tried to change hands and tried to suppress them, they'll suffer.
如果法老想要欺压他们，他们马上就落入苦境。
And we know Pharaoh is not a good king.
我们知道法老不是一个好王。
Pharaoh in the Bible represents the devil, the evil one.
法老在圣经里面就像世界的王，就是魔鬼一样。
Let's turn to the New Testament, 1 John 5, verse 19.
我们来看新约。约翰一书五章十九节。
First John chapter 5 verse 19.
约翰一书五章十九节。我们知道我们是属神的，全世界都握在那恶者手下。
Wow. He tells us that we know we are of God, but the whole world lies under the sway of the wicked one.
我们知道我们是属神的，可是全世界都是握在恶者手下。
Can you imagine if you live in a country, you cannot escape from the government, you cannot escape from the law, you are being influenced, you are under it.
当你活在一个国家，你住在那里，你就会被他的政策、他的法律所影响。
The government, the police, anytime they can apply the law to you.
当这个政策或是警察，他要用这条法律来治你的时候。
Unless you leave the country, otherwise you are bound by it.
除非你离开了那个国家，要不然你就会受到控制。
Spiritually speaking, we are living in the world that is controlled by the evil one.
属灵上来说，我们现在住的世界其实就是那握在恶者手下的世界。
The evil one is invisible, you cannot see him, but his influence is everywhere.
那个恶者我们用肉眼看不见，可是其实他的工作是在我们四周围都有。
Whether who are people who are committing sin, killing people,
不管是有人杀了人
，sexually immoral,
或者是犯了奸淫
，they're using drugs,
或者是吸了毒
，or they are very angry, trying to kill other people, full of anger.
或是他们心里充满仇恨。
All of these bad things are the influence of the wicked one.
所有这一些都是受到那恶者所影响。
So that's why in our life we'll face troubles.
所以我们在生命当中一定会遇到患难。
Now, going back to the story, that it is not coincident. It is not like a random thing that they are mistreated by the Pharaoh.
那我们回到故事来看，他们并不是突然被这样对待。
Actually, God allowed this to happen.
这是神允许发生的事。
Now remember, there's a little bit difference here.
那我们来看，厘清一下。
God did not cause them trouble directly.
神并不是直接让他们遇到患难。
It is Pharaoh who mistreated them.
是法老虐待他们。
However, God allowed Pharaoh to mistreat them.
不过神允许这件事发生。
For another reason.
为了另外一个理由。
So same today when brother and sister or believer face trouble in our life.
所以今天弟兄姐妹，如果你在生命当中遇到了患难。
It is God allowed this to happen.
是神让这件事允许这件事发生的。
For some other reason that we may not understand at the moment, but we understand later.
为了我们现在不懂的原因，可是可能之后我们会明白。
Now, many hundred years before that they went to Egypt, God told Abraham about his plan.
在几百年前，神就已经告诉亚伯拉罕未来的事情。
About their descendant, his descendant will live in Egypt.
就是亚伯拉罕的子孙会住在埃及。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 15, verse 13.
我们来看创世纪十五章十三节。
Genesis chapter 15, verse 13.
创世纪十五章十三节，耶和华对亚伯兰说：“你要的确知道，你的后裔必寄居别人的地，又服侍那地的人。那地的人要苦待他们四百年。”
Verse 14.
十四节，并且他们所要服侍的那国，我要惩罚。后来他们必带着许多财物从那里出来。
You know.This is when God appeared to Abraham a few hundred years before Moses was even born.
这是在摩西都还没有出生之前，神向亚伯拉罕显现所说的话。
God to Abraham. At that time, Abraham didn't even have descendants.
那时候亚伯兰根本就还没有孩子。
Didn't have Isaac, didn't have Jacob, didn't have the 12 tribes.
还没有以撒，没有雅各，没有十二支派。
However, at that time, God already told Abraham that your descendant will be living in Egypt.
那时候神已经告诉亚伯兰说，你的后裔必住在埃及。
Now, brother and sister, do you know what will happen to you next minute?
弟兄姐妹，你知道下一分钟你会发生什么事吗？
Do you know what happened tomorrow?
你知道明天吗？
No, we don't even know tomorrow.
我们并不知道。
But God knows our future.
可是神知道我们的未来。
And our future is in His hand. He's already decided. He already arranged for us.
他已经为我们安排了明天。
Sometimes we don't understand why.
有的时候我们并不明白。
When God told Abraham that your descendant will be living in another people land, didn't mention Egypt here, but living in a stranger land.
神对亚伯兰说，你的后裔必寄居别人的地。
It's not theirs.
他没有告诉他们是埃及。
But the people will cause them to afflict them for 400 years. He even mentioned 400 years.
甚至这里提到要那地的人要苦待他们四百年。
You know, God already has a plan.
神已经有他的计划。
I think if I were Abraham, I would complain. God, why are you okay? You know, do you make a mistake? Why you want my descendant living in a foreign land?
如果我是亚伯兰，我会问神说：“你不要开玩笑吧？为什么我的后裔要受这些苦呢？”
Or if you are to bless me, why you cause them to be afflicted?
如果你祝福我的话，为什么要这样苦待我的百姓呢？
But God has a plan.
可是神有他的计划。
Even if it allow you to suffer, even allow bad things to happen.
甚至他允许他们受苦，允许这些坏事发生。
But in God's plan, there is something better, something good is going to achieve.
可是，在神的计划里，总是有好事会发生在最后。
Because in verse 14 tells us why.
因为十四节告诉我们为什么。
Actually, God will punish the nation.
神其实要惩罚那个国家。
Because Egypt was full of sin.
因为埃及充满罪恶。
So God will punish Egypt.
所以神要惩罚埃及。
And God will bring them out of Egypt.
而且神要带领百姓出埃及。
And then God will let them to have a lot of possession from Egypt.
而且他们要带着许多财物从那里出来。
Oh, this is what is the plan of God.
这是神的计划。
When they stay in Egypt for 400 years, even though they suffer a lot, but they will multiply, they will be blessed.
他们住在埃及虽然被苦待，可是他们会很繁荣，会强盛。
Now let's look at the history then.
我们来看历史。
How long did they stay in Egypt?
他们住在埃及多少年？
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 12 verse 40.
我们来看出埃及记十二章四十节。
Exodus chapter 12 verse 40.
出埃及记十二章四十节，以色列人住在埃及共有四百三十年。
Now this is very interesting.
这是非常有趣的。
God told Abraham, your descendant will live in a foreign land for 400 years.
神告诉亚伯兰说，你的子孙会住在埃及四百年。
And when they left Egypt, the historian said they have spent 430 years in Egypt.
不过在出埃及记记载了说，他们住在埃及有430年。
Wow, very close, right?
这数字是非常接近。
You may ask, then why there's a 30 years difference?
你可能会问，这三十年是哪里来的？
Well, maybe the 30 years they enjoyed good life, they were not persecuted.
很有可能这三十年就是他们最刚开始的时候，他们没有受到迫害。
And then another 400 years, wow, they live a tough life.
那之后的四百年很有可能就落入苦难中。
The life get tougher and tougher.
生活过得越来越苦。
So what we learn here is, you know, even though you don't know your tomorrow, but it is in God's hand.
所以我们这里学到就是说，虽然我们不知道明天，可是都在神的手中。
If you are the children of God,
如果你是神的儿女
，you don't have to worry.
你不用担心。
Even sometimes suddenly, wow, things turn very bad. Or like you lose your health, or you lose your money, or you have a very bad luck, or it seems that bad things happen to you.
很有可能我们一夜之间失去了健康，失去了金钱，我们遇到很不好的事情。
Just like the Israelites, overnight, wow, the new king came and then they suffer.
就像以色列人一样，一夜之间新的王起来，他们就落入苦难当中。
But don't forget, God is in control.
可是不要忘记，这都在神的掌握当中。
Let's turn to John chapter 16, verse 33.
我们来看约翰福音十六章三十三节。
John chapter 16, verse 33.
约翰福音十六章三十三节。我将这些事告诉你们，是要叫你们在我里面有平安。在世上你们有苦难，但你们可以放心，我已经胜了世界。
Oh, here the Bible said, Jesus did not say that, oh, you believe in me, you'll be free of trouble.
耶稣在这里并没有告诉我们说，哦，你只要相信我，你什么苦难都没有。
If you believe in me, you will not go bankrupt, you will not have COVID, you will not have cancer, you will live, you know, everybody 90 years old.
你如果相信我，你就可以活到九十岁、一百岁，然后永远健康、长命百岁。
Or you don't have family problem, you will not face troubles.
你也不会有经济的问题，也不会有家庭的问题。
No, Jesus did not promise us this.
不，主耶稣并没有保证这些。
Don't forget, we are living in the world under Pharaoh.
不要忘记，我们是住在法老掌管的世界里。
We were born to the world.
我们是生在这个世界上。
We face a lot of troubles, hardship.
我们会遇到很多患难。
Sometimes people betray us, they hurt us.
甚至被人们伤害，被人们背叛。
And then sometimes we get old and we get sick.
当我们年老的时候，或许会失去健康。
Some people die old, some people die young.
有些人在年老时死去，有些人甚至年轻的时候就走了。
We are living in the world under Pharaoh, and the world is full of trouble because of sin.
那这个世界因为是握在恶者手下，所以呢充满了罪恶。
However, Jesus here promises one thing.
可是主耶稣在这里向我们保证一点。
Yes, I tell you that in Jesus, you may have peace.
在我里面，你们有平安。
In this world, you have tribulation.
在世界上，你们有苦难。
Yes, if you follow the Bible reading schedule, if you read the book of Exodus, a lot of tribulation, a lot of hardship, a lot of test.
如果我们跟着读经进度来读，我们就会发现出埃及记里面有非常多的苦难和患难。
However, in God, under Moses, under the guidance of the Almighty God, they have, if they follow God, they will have peace.
但是在神的带领之下，他们会得到平安。
But if they don't follow God, they lose the peace.
但是如果他们不跟从神，他们就会失去了这个平安。
So brother and sister, think about you and I today.
所以弟兄姐妹，今天想想你和我。
Yeah, maybe our life is good. We thank God.
或许我们今天过得很好，我们感谢神。
But maybe your life having challenges, you still have to remain in Him.
那如果你的生命受到了挑战，你还是要待在他里面。
Now remember, suffering is destined. You cannot escape.
记得患难是命定的，我们没办法逃脱。
It's just a matter of time.
只是时间的问题。
However, we don't have to be afraid.
但是我们不要害怕。
Because in Him we will have peace.
因为主耶稣说，在他里面有平安。
Everything is under His control.
任何事都在他的控制之中。
Then second point, why we say grace in the midst of suffering?
那第二点就是为什么我们会遇到患难？
Because suffering makes us look upon God.
因为苦难会让我们仰望神。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 1, verse 11 to 14.
我们来看出埃及记第一章十一节到十四节。
Exodus chapter 1, verse 11 to 14.
出埃及记第一章十一到十四节。十一节，于是埃及人派督工的辖制他们，加重担苦害他们。他们为法老建造两座基货城，就是比东和兰塞。
Verse 12。
十二，只是越发苦害他们，他们越发多起来，越发蔓延。埃及人就因以色列人愁烦。
Verse 13.
13. 埃及人严严地使以色列人做工。
14.
14. 使他们因做苦工觉得命苦，无论是和泥，是做砖，是做田间各样的工，在一切的工上都严严地待他们。
Now look at life change overnight, and suddenly the Pharaoh afflicted them with a lot of hard labor.
我们看他们一夜之间就变成做苦工的奴隶了。
They were a guest under Pharaoh, but now they are slaves.
他们本来是法老的客人，是座上宾，可是现在突然变成奴隶。
Now think about us right now. We are immigrant in Canada, right? We have a house, we have money, we have a Canadian citizen status.
看看，我们都是加拿大的移民，我们有房子、有钱，我们也有公民权。
Wow, this is we enjoy freedom here.
我们很享受这里的自由。
But can you imagine if I'm not saying that it will happen, right? If overnight the government say, oh, all the Chinese, all the doesn't care whether you're Taiwan, China, you just look Chinese, you're in the labor camp.
那如果说有一夜之间，政府告诉你说，只要你长得像东方人，不管你是哪一国的人，你就要当奴隶。
Right. You're Asian, you're in the labor camp.
你就是从亚洲来的人，
you know,
你就要进这个苦工营。
You know, during the Second World War, the Japanese Canadian, they were all kind of arrested and they put into the central camp in the interior because they think that all the Canadian Japanese may aid the enemy in Japan.
在第二次世界大战之后，加拿大。就把日本人
二战的时候
加拿大政府把
Canadian Japanese
在加拿大的日本人抓起来，因为他们觉得所有的日本人都是坏的。
And then they put into the camp in the interior
放在集中营里面。
Yeah, of course they don't kill them like the Nazi, but they just lock them up or limited them the freedom.
当然他没有像纳粹这样杀他们，可是也是限制了他们的行动。
Overnight they would lose their freedom.
一夜之间，他们就失去了自己的自由。
Or recently, we look at the news, right? The indigenous people, they were mistreated by the government. They put them in the residential school.
最近我们都知道新闻里面提到，原住民在几十年前受到了政府的错待。
This is they live a very tough life.
他们那时候的命非常的苦。
Now look at the Israelites. Overnight, from a very honored citizen or a very very welcome guest, suddenly they became.Like a slave and hard labor.
我们看这里的以色列人也是一样，他们本来是法老的座上宾，可是突然一夜之间变成了奴隶。
I think in their hearts, there is always a question.
我想在他们的心中应该有很大的问号。
Why? Why? Why?
为什么呢
？Why us?
为什么会这样呢
？What have I done? What have we done?
我们做了什么呢
？And why God allowed this to happen to us?
为什么神让这件事发生呢
？If you are God, why you allow this to happen?
如果你是我的神，为什么你让这样的事发生呢
？Of course, they don't get the answer. Of course, we know the answer because we read the whole book. We just like from the perspective of God, looking at the whole thousands of years with the same moment.
当然，我们从神的角度来看，从历史的眼光来看，我们知道后来发生什么事。
But at that moment, they didn't understand why. They have a lot of questions.
可是，在他们受苦的当下，他们并不知道为什么。
But there's one side effect of suffering. There's one side effect.
这里有一个受苦的后遗症，
副作用 is that suffering caused them to look upon God，
就是苦难让他们仰望神。
Let's turn to chapter 2 verse 23。
我们看第二章第三节。
Chapter 2 verse 23。
第二章二十三节。过了多年，埃及王死了，以色列人因做苦工就叹息哀求，他们的哀声达于神。
Wow, he said the people started to cry and cry.And they started to pray to God.
以色列人他们开始祷告，然后哀声就达于神。
You know, at the beginning, didn't mention that when their life is very good, they pray to God.
在他们日子过得很好的时候，这里并没有记载他们祷告。
Actually, to be honest, right? If life is very good, do you really need to pray or not?
其实说实话，我们如果生活过得很好，我们需要祷告吗
？You're very healthy.
你很健康。
No sickness.
没有生病。
And then your job is very stable. Your business is very good.
你的工作、你的薪水都非常好。
Your marriage is perfect.
你的婚姻很美满。
Your children is 100% obedient and they follow your expectation.
你的孩子符合你的期待，非常的乖。
You have good friends. You have vacation every month. You have the money you never finish spending.
你有好朋友，你也有很多的假期。
Do you think you need to pray?
你想你需要祷告吗
？Think about this, right? A perfect life. Actually, you want to pray, but what do you want to pray for?
如果你过的是一个完美的生活，到底你要向神祷告什么呢
？But think about you and I.
可是想一想
，When was the last time you pray the hardest, the most earnest, even crying, even if you feel God so close to you.
想一想上一次最靠近现在的上一次，你是如何向神迫切的祷告、流泪祷告，觉得神与你非常的亲近。
I don't think it's the time you feel very smooth or very blessed.
我想这个时刻肯定不是你蒙大福的时候。
But rather, I think it's the time when you suffer the most.
一定是你觉得你最苦的时候。
But that is the moment that you feel you need God, and you start to find strength, even though you cannot get answer, but at least you try to find strength from Him.
就是在那个时刻，你觉得你与神最靠近，就算你没有得到答案，可是你也觉得你可以从他支取力量。
And when they pray to God, God answered the prayer.
当你祷告向神传达你的哀声，神就回答了你的祷告。
Let's read verse 24, chapter 2, verse 24.
我们来看一样，出埃及记二章二十四节，神听见他们的哀声，就纪念他与亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各所立的约。
25.
25节，神看顾以色列人，也知道他们的苦情。
Wow, he said when they are suffering, when they pray to God, God answer them. God remember the covenant.
这里讲说，神纪念他与亚伯拉罕所立的约。
So why do we say there are grace in the midst of suffering? Why do we say there is grace in the midst of suffering?
为什么我们说在患难当中有恩典呢？
Because suffering will push us to grow, to draw close to God.
因为苦难会催逼我们更亲近神。
Let's turn to Psalm 120, verse 1.
我们来看诗篇120篇第一节。
Psalm 120, verse 1.
诗篇120篇第一节。我在极难中求告耶和华，他就应允我。
Wow, this is how suffering became a grace.
这时候就是苦难变成恩典。
Why?
为什么？
Because it brings you closer to God.
因为催逼一个人成长，去趋向神。
In another city, another place, there was a brother.
在另外一个城市，有个弟兄。
He run a barber shop and a very busy, earning money every day.
他开一个理发店，每天都非常的忙。
And a lot of preacher tried to encourage him, saying that, you know, you should take Saturday off, close the store so that you can observe Sabbath.
有不少神的工人告诉他说，你应该在安息日把店关起来，到教会来守安息日。
He said that there's no way we can do it because Saturday is the busiest, and I earn the best income on Saturday.
他说我在礼拜六最忙，客人最多，怎么可能呢？
Even though financially he can do this, but he don't want to do it.
其实，在他的经济上他是可以这样做的，可是他不想这么做。
Because he feel that I cannot let go all this income.
因为他觉得他不能放过这些客人，在礼拜六离去。
However, God loved him and his family.
不过神爱他与他的家。
One of his child later was disturbed by the demon.
他其中的一个孩子有一天就被魔鬼所搅扰。
Wow, and then one of the child is a girl and the daughter. You know, sometimes she's off control, lose sense of herself.
这个女孩她被魔鬼搅扰之后，她就常常做出无意识的动作。
And then become very violent.
他变得非常暴力。
But when the devil disappeared, and then she became normal.
当魔鬼离开的时候，他又变得很正常。
However, when the devil came to disturb her, she's off control again.
不过当魔鬼又出现的时候，他就又失去控制了。
Wow, this brings a lot of suffering for the whole family.
这对这个家的冲击非常的大。
Even though they bring her to see a doctor, give her medicine, didn't solve the problem.
就算带她去看医生，吃了药也没办法解决。
Even they want to lock her up in the psychiatric ward.
他们最后还想把她关在精神病院。
But we know that if a person is locked up in a psychiatric ward, a mental hospital, usually they don't come out easily.
我们知道，如果人被关在精神病院，其实是很难出来的。
And then maybe the situation may become more serious.
可能到后来就会越来越严重。
Now this family, the brother, but his wife think that this time we got to rely on God.
这时候，这位弟兄跟他的太太就决定要依靠神。
If you don't have peace,
如果你没有平安
，Even though we earn so much money, what is that for?
你赚再多的钱都没用。
So they decided we have to fast and pray.
他们决定要禁食祷告。
And then they have to think that you know what we have been lacking in the past is because we don't worship God, we don't keep the Sabbath.
他们觉得因为我们没有守安息日，我们没有敬拜神。
So they decided, okay, we'll close Saturday.
他们决定在礼拜六要把理发店关起来。
We want God to have mercy on us to help our child, otherwise we don't have any hope.
我们求神来怜悯我们的孩子。
So just like this verse tells us, in their distress they cry out to God.
就像这一节告诉我们，在急难中求告神。
And God hear their prayer, and God help them.
神就会听见，会帮助。
Later they pray so hard, and the church brother and sister come and pray, and they cast out the demon.
啊，所以他们就非常努力祷告，教会的弟兄姐妹也来帮忙赶鬼。
Now look at this example that we read the Israelites.
那我们看回来，这以色列人这件事。
If they live a very good life, if no Pharaoh mistreat them.
如果法老没有对偏待他们，对他们非常好。
I think the situation would be like this.
我想情况是会这样的。
They really enjoy life.
他们日子过得很好。
And then they don't know what to pray for.
他们也不知道祷告什么。
They don't think they need God.
他们觉得不需要神。
And they enjoy Egypt so much.
他们很享受每一天。
Egypt is a nice place.
哦，在埃及，是一个很好的地方。
Why do we have to go?
我们为什么要离开呢？
Even if God tell them, you know, there's a promised land somewhere, they will tell God, say, hey, we don't need that. Where Egypt is our home.
就算神告诉他们说，在某个地方有个应许之地是要给你们的，他们一定会拒绝。
I don't want to go. We want to be in Egypt.
我们不想去，我们想留在埃及。
But suffering make them they don't like Egypt anymore.
可是苦难当中，他们觉得他们再也不爱埃及了。
Yeah, maybe in the past we had a good life, but now it's suffering.
或许在过去日子过得不错，可是现在他们在受苦。
This place doesn't belong to us.
他们就会萌出一个想法，就是这地不属于我们。
I really longing to some place where God has prepared.
我想要去神为我预备的地方。
So this is exactly suffering push a person to grow up.
所以就是苦难催逼一个人的信仰会成长。
This even happened in the family for young people.
这也会发生在。家庭里面
if a family, if a child live a very good life, usually it mature very slowly.
如果一个孩子在一个非常一个美满的家庭里面长大，通常他会成熟的比较晚。
But if a very tough life push the child to grow up, to be independent, to strive for himself.
如果小孩从小就受苦，就会逼他快点长大成熟。
Spiritually, even though we don't like to suffer, but God sometimes look at us and say, "Hey, the only way to make you to grow is to let you suffer a little bit."
属灵上也是一样，有时候我们并不想要长大，可是神会用苦难催逼我们长大。
Another example I want to share with you.
另外一个例子。
There's a young couple in another city.
在另外一个城市有一对夫妻。
Wow, now they have a child.
他们有一个孩子。
At the beginning they're very happy.
刚开始他们过得很好。
They think that God blessed them with a child.
他们觉得神很祝福他们的孩子。
But later when the child was born, find out that there's some defect. There's some, the baby was born with some illness.
他们发现孩子出生之后呢，有一些奇怪的现象，就是生病了。
Actually, there was a genetic problem, the genetic illness.
是基因的缺陷。
There's nothing can heal, no medicine can be used.
是没有药物可以帮忙的。
At the beginning, they feel so upset, they feel so sorrow, so saddened.
在刚开始，他们非常的忧愁。
Oh, why? Why did this happen to us?
为什么这件事会发生在我们身上呢？
What have we done wrong?
我们做错了什么吗？
Of course, they cannot find the answer.
当然，他们找不到答案。
And they almost lost their faith.
他们差一点要失去了信心。
However, they keep praying.
可是他们一直祷告。
The preacher encouraged them.
传道勉励他们。
No matter what happened, you don't lose hope. Do not lose faith in God.
不要失去对神的信心，不要失去希望。
If God allowed this to happen, there must be for a reason.
如果神让这件事发生，一定有他的目的。
At that time, they don't understand what's the reason.
在那时候，他们并不明白为什么。
But they decided, you know, since this already happened, we'll just rely on God to live every single day.
可是他们决定，既然这件事发生了，我们就要更加仰望神。
Raising this kid with handicap, with mental or genetic problem is not easy.
要抚养这样有缺陷的孩子并不容易。
But since God has given this to us,
那神已经给我们了。
We have to be strong, we have to be brave, we have to love the child even more than a normal child.
我们要坚强，我们要这样带领着我们的孩子。
We have to love the child even more than a normal baby.
我们要爱这个孩子更多，比别的孩子更多。
In God's eyes, this baby is precious.
在神的眼中，这个孩子是珍宝。
Wow, so this couple, since that, they pray every single day.
所以在这件事发生之后，这对夫妻祷告更多了。
Every morning they fast and pray for God to give them strength and pray for the child.
每天早上，他们都禁食祷告，为了这个孩子，为了自己的信仰。
That didn't change the health situation because, as I mentioned, it's a genetic problem.
其实这并没有改变这孩子的现象，因为这是基因的缺陷。
However, they feel they got strength from God and they love from God. They love the baby.
可是他们发现，他们对孩子的爱更多，对神的爱也更多了。
And they feel that God is with them every single day.
他们觉得神每一天都与他们同在。
So that is the grace amidst in the midst of suffering.
所以这就是在患难当中遇到了恩典。
Let's turn to Romans, the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 35.
我们来看罗马书八章三十五节。
It's a very beautiful passage here.
是一个很美好的讯息。
Romans chapter 8, verse 35.
罗马书八章三十五节。三十五节，谁能使我们与基督的爱隔绝呢？难道是患难吗？是困苦吗？是逼迫吗？是饥饿吗？是赤身肉体吗？是危险吗？是刀剑吗？
Here Paul said, "What can separate us from the love of Christ?"
这里保罗问到，谁能使我们与基督的爱隔绝呢？
Let's say, "What can separate love?"
我们来说，谁能
？What can separate love between two persons?
怎么样可以把两个人分开？相爱的人。
Let's say if a couple is dating, right? If they know each other.
我们说，如果两个人在谈恋爱的时候
，there must be some factor, some reason why they are attracted to each other.
一定有一些理由是他们互相吸引的原因。
Maybe because they're beautiful.
可能因为长得很好看。
Smart.
或者是很聪明。
Humorous.
或者是幽默。
Or wealth.
或者是财富。
That make them attracted to each other.
这让他们互相吸引。
So if you take away all this factor.
如果你把这一些因素都拿走
，Usually you take away the love.
通常你就把爱拿走了。
They say, "Oh, bye bye, no more. I'm not suffering with you."
哦，我再也不跟你在一起了。
This is because love, a lot of situation is very superficial, very conditional.
因为常常这些是有条件的爱，是非常表面的。
But there are one love, true love is not conditional.
但是有一种真爱是没有条件的。
Even suffering, you cannot separate them.
就算受苦。患难都没有办法分开。
This is the love of God.
这就是神的爱。
God loves us so much, He came to the world and suffered for us.
神的爱是非常的伟大，他来到这个世界为我们受苦。
Just like God sent Moses to bring them out of Egypt.
就像神差摩西去带领他们出埃及。
God loves them so much.
神非常爱他们。
Paul understand this love.
保罗非常明白这个爱。
If God loves me so much.
如果神这么爱我
，He can die for me on the cross.
他可以为我在十字架上死。
He can shed His blood.
他可以流出他的血。
Then even today, if I face tribulation for Him,
那就算今天我为了他面对这些苦难
，I will not stop loving God.
我不会停止去爱神的。
So here mentioned that shall tribulation, distress, persecution, famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword.
所以这里提到，难道是患难、困苦、逼迫、饥饿、赤身肉体、危险吗？
Paul said, "None of this can separate him from the love of Lord Jesus Christ."
保罗说这些完全不能隔绝他与基督的爱。
So today, brother and sister, think about you and I, our faith.
所以今天弟兄姐妹，反观我们的信仰。
Do we love Jesus because He has treated us very well or give a lot of blessing?
我们爱神是因为他对我们很好，赐给我们很多恩典吗
？Or do you love Him because He has sacrificed Himself for you?
或者是你爱他是因为他先爱了你。
He has sacrificed his life for you on the cross.
他为你牺牲他的生命在十架上。
And today, no matter what happened, I am not departing from him.
今天不管发生什么事，我绝对不分开。
So faith will grow in the midst of suffering.
所以信仰是会在苦难当中成长的。
And sometimes faith is even been tested by the suffering.
有时候信仰也会在苦难当中被试验。
Let's look at this chapter. There's two characters very interesting.
我们来看，有两个人是非常有趣的。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 1, verse 15.
我们来看出埃及记第一章
，verse 15，
第十五节。
Exodus chapter 1, verse 15 to 16.
出埃及记第一章十五十六节，有希伯来的两个收生婆，一名施弗拉，一名普阿。埃及王对他们说
：“16，
十六，你们为希伯来妇人收身，看他们临盆的时候，若是男孩，就把他杀了；若是女孩，就留他存活。”
Now, not only the Israelites are facing tests because of hard labor.
这里不只有以色列人因做苦工而被而受苦
，being tested, so 试炼
而被试炼。
But now there are two midwives. Her faith, their faith, also being tested.
这里有两个收生婆，他们的信仰也被试炼。
Now, brother and sister, you don't know how much faith you got unless you are tested.
弟兄姐妹，你不知道你的信心到底有多少，直到你被试验的时候。
You come here to the church every day under the air condition, and then you listen service doesn't mean you have good faith.
你坐在这里吹着冷气听着道，不代表你有信心。
You can come to church every day doesn't mean you have good faith.
你可以每天都来，可是也不代表你有信心。
Your faith will only show when you are facing a choice, facing a decision.
当你面对挑战、面对选择的时候，才显示出你有多少信心。
Now at the time of Pharaoh, they want to destroy the people. They want to limit the suppress the population growth of the Israelites.
那时候法老他想要限制他们以色列人。
He has a very wicked scheme.
所以他有一个很邪恶的想法。
He tell the two midwives of the Hebrew came.
他告诉两个希伯来的收生婆
commanded them that if a baby boy were born, you kill them.
告诉他们说，如果是希伯来妇人收生，在临盆的时候，男孩就要把他杀了。
And if it's a woman, if a baby girl, you leave them alive.
若是生的是女孩，就可以留她存活。
Wow, this Pharaoh is very, very wicked, very cruel.
这个法老非常的残忍。
Why?
为什么
？Because they know that by killing all the boys, all the baby boys.In the future generation, all the baby girl left, they will marry Egyptian.
因为他知道，如果把男孩都杀了，那这一整代的女孩长大了就会嫁给埃及人。
Because at the beginning, the Hebrew baby, when they grow up, Hebrew man, Hebrew young man, young lady, they get married. They don't mix with Egypt.
因为当希伯来人他们长大，从小长大之后，他们会互相嫁娶给希伯来人。
They will keep their race, they will keep their ethnic, they will keep their religion.
那么会保持他们纯种，然后也会保持他们的信仰。
But if they kill the boys, and then the lady, the baby girl grow up, they have to marry Egyptian. They have no choice.
可是如果杀了男孩，女孩长大之后就一定要嫁给埃及人，因为他们没有选择。
And then, two or three generations later, there will be no Hebrew. They're all Egyptian.
两三代之后就会全部都是埃及人了。
Wow, Pharaoh is very wicked.
埃及王非常的邪恶。
He knows how to destroy the faith of the Hebrews.
他知道如何摧毁希伯来人的信心。
By mixing them the marriage with unbelievers or the local Egyptian，
让他们与埃及人生下混血，所以他们就会被消灭。
Today the devil doing the same tricks。
今天魔鬼用同样的手法。
If a believer they marry unbeliever, the faith is not the same. The sooner or later the faith cannot be passed on。
如果一个信徒与未信者结婚，很快的他们下一代或是下下一代就会消失。
So the faith will be lost。
这个信仰就不见了。
So now these two midwives, they have this a very strict command from the king.
这时候两个收生婆他们接收到这么残酷的命令。
Now you think about this, right? If you and I, you are the midwife, you are standing beside the Pharaoh, who is the most powerful person on earth at the time.
如果你是那个收生婆，你当时站在法老面前，他是当时最伟大的统治者。
Don't forget, Egypt was the superpower.
不要忘了，埃及是一个强权。
Nobody can compare to Pharaoh.
没有人可以与法老
Pharaoh tell you to do this, and you must do it.
法老告诉你，你就这么做。
But however, what did they do? They face the test now.
可是两个收生婆遭遇到考验了。
As we said, you don't know how much faith you have until you are tested.
就像我们刚刚讲的，你不知道你的信仰程度如何，直到你遇到了考验。
Are you able to stand firm to say no to Pharaoh, or you will just do whatever he wants you to do?
你敢勇敢地站出来说不，或者是你就听话。
Let's read verse 17.
我们来看十七节。
Verse 17。
十七节，但是收生婆敬畏神，不照埃及王的吩咐行，竟存留男孩的性命。
Wow, here said they fear God and they did not do as the king commanded them.
这里讲到收生婆敬畏神，不照埃及王的吩咐行。
So how can we receive grace in the midst of suffering and test?
那我们要如何在考验当中得到恩典呢
？You have to be brave. You have to make the choice that according to God, not according to Your fear.
你要有真正的勇气，不是惧怕法老王，而是惧怕神。
You know, brother and sister, sometimes before that happens, we have to think about this.
有时候我们面对事件的发生，我们会这样想。
We have to before it happens, we have to be prepared.
我们要先做心理准备。
If I listen to the Pharaoh, what will happen?
如果我听了法老，那会发生什么事呢
？Yes, maybe I can live longer.
可能我会活久一点。
But I still die one day.
可是有一天我还是得死。
But if I kill all the babies of the Hebrews,
可是如果我杀了所有希伯来的男孩
，What will God do to me?
以后神会怎么对我呢
？I think this has gone through in the mind of the two midwives.
我想这个一定是收生婆头脑里面在想的事情。
Oh, that I have to choose one side.
我一定要选一边。
If you cannot please both, of course it will be good if you can please both.
当然，如果两边你都可以讨好的话，你可以这样做。
But if I have to choose one side, which side do I want to please?
可是如果你只能选一边，那哪一边是你想要顺从的呢
？Oh, you know, this may cause suffering.
这个可能会有后果。
Are you ready to pay the price?
你准备好了吗？
However, this midwife, they have decided we are going to listen to God.
可是收生婆他们选择敬畏神。
They fear God and they don't destroy, they don't kill the baby boys.
他们敬畏神，存留男孩的性命。
And because of this, God bless them.
所以因为这样，神就祝福他们。
And also God bless the people.
神也祝福以色列人。
So, brother, sister, when we are in suffering, sometimes we have to make a choice.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们在苦难当中，有时候是必须做选择的。
That choice sometimes will put you into a disadvantage or even a risky position.
有时候会把你放到一个很危险的境地。
However, we got to rely on God.
我们要仰望神。
That is no other option.
我们是没有选择的。
So next time we face troubles, face suffering.
所以下一次当我们遇到困难挑战的时候，
Remember, this could be the grace that God is going to bestow on you.
想一想，这很有可能是神要降恩典在你身上的时候。
Helping your faith to grow.
帮助你信仰成长。
Let you experience Him even more.
让你与他更亲近，体验到他。
Let's sing Him 166.
我们一起来唱诗166首。